If you're using BrightSign players for digital signage, but looking for software that's easier for your team to use, then this video is for you. I'm Peter Anselmo, I'm the CTO and co-founder of SmarterSign. For the last 20 years, we've helped thousands of companies deploy digital signage networks and use them to effectively communicate with their customers and employees. For most of these networks, content is displayed on the screens using a digital signage player. There are so many options for digital signage players, but today we're going to talk about one of the most popular choices, the BrightSign player. I'll get into what we like about these players, but I'll also let you know one of the most common complaints that people have about BrightSign. BrightSign has been around for years, and they have a long track record of making reliable digital signage players. The price point tends to be a little higher than other options, especially when you compare the overall performance. With that being said, these players are a great choice for companies that are able to deal with a more sophisticated initial setup. These beautiful looking purple boxes easily mount behind a screen and in most cases will run reliably for years. When I have conversations with businesses that are using BrightSign players, any negative feedback is never about the hardware. It's about the software that they're using to create and distribute the content. I recently got off a call with a museum in Ohio that uses BrightSign devices and the BrightAuthor software to display their message and their content throughout the building. While there are no complaints about the players, they felt that the learning curve to use the software was too steep for their staff. Because of this, when changes need to be made to the signs, it becomes the job of one or two people that have been trained to use the software. This is a problem when weather forces them to cancel an outdoor event or make changes that are time sensitive. This is a call that we get often, and that was the reason that we added BrightSign support for the SmarterSign software. Since we started working with our first client back in 2006, we understood that software should be easy to use, but that should not come at the expense of enterprise features. One of my favorite quotes is from Alan Kay. Simple things should be simple and complex things should be possible. This has been one of our core beliefs here at SmarterSign. You get powerful features like advanced scheduling, enterprise logins, and user permissions. What this means is that your team members will only see the functionality that they've been assigned. When they log in, they will see a streamlined version of the system specifically for their role. If you have BrightSign players and you want to learn about using SmarterSign, you can schedule a call with myself or another member of my team here. I'm going to put a link in the description below. During the call, we can discuss how you're using your BrightSign players, what your challenges are, and what a migration plan would look like. We also have a fully functioning free trial of SmarterSign Manager, so you can see for yourself what SmarterSign has to offer. You can explore the content creation tools, how to schedule content, and test out one or more of your BrightSign players with the SmarterSign software. Thank you.